more interesting things here. My ACU. I have a Bosch.
Bosch.
And that's it. With a K-line dedicated wire, 45th pin. I have plugged it to the Rostec. Also requires a minus and a plus. You can check the faults. For a vehicle speed input, I bought a holo sensor, which I believe, I am hoping, is going to give me a sense of speed. For this purpose, I'm going to need a 3D printer and a special speed generator. Simple holo sensor, which I believe is using everybody. Pin number one for the positive input, number two for the ground, and the signal output. Connected the sensor positive to the positive terminal, negative to the negative, and output signal to the ECU, pin 51. This is a speedometer. That's the plate that it's supposed to feel the movement, and my movement generator moving. Let's have a look, try to generate the movement that the actual car is moving, and yes, €2 vehicle speed sensor, and it's working. Yes. I reckon I found the perfect material where I can sit the actual sensor. Yeah, fits nicely. Too good. The 3D printer. First of all, I separated the wires. Okay, so that sits in the front, this plate front. Now this is sitting like that, and it looks very promising. Closer look into the sensor itself, and everything is fabricated from a wire connector. Plated the sensor, took my speed generator. Let's have a look, do we have the signal? Yeah, we do. Beautiful. I can feel already my cruise control is running.
I am passing the wires through this hole, and this is a permanent minus, and this is plus from the ignition. It's going to be looking like that. The first goes to the first.
Firstly, I was trying to solder it to this connection, but it appeared like it's mission impossible. And here you go. This is why it's hidden inside.
And I'm going to leave this like separate and connect it a different way.
Prototype of the cruise control switch. This will actuate the cruise control to the ECU. These are going to do something. I'm pressing and it's giving a signal. For the clutch and brake pedal sensors, I fabricated a bracket and I'm going to bolt them here. And I'm going to use original Audi A4 sensors, and they are going to be fitted through these things. I will try to explain my cruise control. At first we need to activate it, and to activate cruise control it requires to enable it, and it's 11463. Do it. Here should appear a G letter in front of that digit 00. Do it. Switching off the ignition, turning on the ignition. Yeah, we have the G letter. It means that the actual cruise control is activated, and now we can see the measuring blocks. Number 6. Explaining the switches, this fixed switch is going to turn on the last bit, and it's the ACU pin number 19, and it's fed through the ignition live positive. And in order to turn on the actual cruise control, according to the forum, it requires two last bits as one. And this means we need to join number 35 and 19 with a fixable switch. Join the two wires, as I told earlier before, 19 and pin 35. And now we have two last digits as a ones, which means that we have cruise control on. Other two switches is changing also the bits. Fourth bit is setting up the cruise control, and the third bit is resuming, okay? But gee, how are you going to use your cruise control if your half of the brake pedal is pressed? And as I can see, I'm not pressing anything, so pin number 9 is not getting any signal. If I am giving it a positive signal, nothing changes, and maybe the negative will change it, and it is changing. So to turn on the cruise control, it requires a negative. Negative is permanently connected. Testing the pedals, pressing the clutch, changing the bit, pressing the brake, changing the bit. Now I don't really understand why the ECU asks for a ground to change the bit from pressed to not pressed, but maybe I fucked it up something or something like that.
In the middle of the fabrication, the cruise control switch, in my head it was looking a little bit nicer, but anyways, it's finished. In case in the future I will sort something like nicer or something, I can easily just disconnect the plug and change it.
For Tacho, I want to do the Mechano conversion. Mechano is a member from one of the forums.
Disassembled, and it's in really, really poor condition. A lot of pieces broken, and make a direct connection to the force leg, input leg.
Now I'm going to use a very, very thin wire. Checking the continuity. Okay. I'm going to prepare the edges for the box glue.
I was fixing the actual bracket with hot glues. I was trying the epoxy glues, but it was very difficult. Also, I have cleaned the washers for the connecting towers.
Oh my god!
I have placed my ECU here, fabricated the plate, holding plate. Looks really professional. Getting the wiring harness. Wiring harness done, not much left here. A quick wash of the engine bay. Looks really, really better. Nice and shiny, no debris.
Now, with all this work done, let's finally test it, shall we?
Increasing the speed.
bought a new clutch and it's weird, a little bit weird. Anyways, stopping.
This is basically it. I have finished my conversion. Thank you for watching and bye for now. I'll see you next time.